Excuse me. We are on television, aren't we? We are on air. So I can't do this stuff like that. Okay. All right, we'll play a song instead.
In a band called Deckchairs Overboard, which I think has always been one of my favourite titles for a band. Don't you think it's funny? I mean, I think it is. I don't know why.
From Deck Chairs Overboard to Split Enz. What? How'd the transition happen?
I rang them up continually and asked me, you know, can I join? Can I now? As soon as I could, I left the Deck Chairs.
Right, and understand there was a bit of a test to pass.
Yeah, there was an intelligence test, and, you know, if you get enough questions wrong, you get in the band. Of course, you know, I got more wrong than anyone. Right.
I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce you to our new drummer, Paul Hester and his yo-yo. Say a few words, Paul, say a few words. Come on. Cat appears to have got Paul's tongue, so we'll just move right along.
Did you find it difficult coming into a group that are already very established and well-known? Is that a hard thing to do?
No, it was easy.
Was it?
So easy.
What, because they're such lovely people?
Yeah.
I'm getting some. Wow! And Frank Dundee. Life on the road, eh?
Somebody Split then? If you've not really been with it for all that long, do you feel disappointed that you've not had maybe such a run as everybody else?
No, not in the slightest. I'm pleased it's finishing. I've got something to do with Neil, and basically it's time to do it now. You know, it's good that it's come to an end. I mean, we all want it to end. Nobody wants it to continue, especially me.
Before you came on. Paul, what has the audience reaction been like to obviously a very well known face here and the rest of you know?
Well,
what if people come in and expect too much, or are they happy with what they get?
Well, you know, when we play a couple of, who was that?
It was Craig, old Dobby.
When we play a couple of the older songs, you know, they all come up the front and sort of, you know, all that sort of stuff. But it's surprising that a lot of people like Mick.
This is a very friendly band. This is their first meeting.
What about the show for you, Paul, as a drummer? Because your drum kit's really strange. And before you used to be helped out with Noel on percussion, but now you're on your own.
Strange. You're really strange.
You've only got half the stuff there. Where's the rest of it?
No, I've got cymbals now. I haven't used cymbals for 5 years because I couldn't afford them. And I had this debt at Billy Hyde's and they used to chase me around. Now I got out of that, so I got another one. So now I got a big kit now, Andrew.
They look pretty small.
Well, maybe it's because I'm growing now, because I'm, 13 this year. So I'm sort of developing.
He's 5'2". We measured him the other day. He's growing up.
What do you want, Proud Mary?
Well, yeah, I was going to get you boys excited, actually. Oh, it's the way to go. Bones, eat your hearts out.
Embarrassing.
There you go. Hello. Lloydie, Chinese, how are you? What are you doing, mate?
Hi. Welcome to yoga. Now, this is the thing
Darren
I like
Hinch,
to do
mate.
Most
turn him off. He's an idiot. The guy should be put
space,
away.
Stretch, mark one.
Oh, good.
Here we go. Okay.
Hey, listen. When are you gonna come over? What is me?
Yeah.
I get pizza containers.
Paul, I don't think you're being serious now.
And rip them up and throw them out the bus door and they go...
That happened. That happened really? One night in Detroit. We were playing in Motor City. Mm. And Paul, they there were all these fans outside the bus. And they were just all going crazy. And anything, they wanted stuff, you know. They'd just stand there saying, we want.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what it is. And Paul just got... We'd had a pizza and Paul got the pizza container and just... pushed the door open and threw it out to them and they just like tore it apart.
It was great. I remember when I got a bit of Elton's pizza container back in 73, I think I was, no, pizza's went out then. That's right, I got a bit of his Kentucky Fried bones he threw at me. And then I went to see McCartney and he came out from the encore and he had a rock and he flicked it and went, and I went, oh, Mecca, I love ya.
And I know I'm right. First time in my life, that's why I tell you, you'd better be home soon. That is why I stumble to my knees. You're heading down to be someone that you've seen in a magazine. Premonition is coming true. Oh baby, you're not so green. No baby, you're not so green. No baby, you're not so systematically waking up the dead. Yep. Systematically stepping on my head. Systematically waking up the dead. Uh-huh. Systematically stepping on my head. We'll be right back.
I've got this deal on paper, and Tim's had to buy into the company, and it's cost him $333 to buy into the Crowded House Touring Inc., and he's now a secretary.
We're one member less now, and we're looking for the fourth person, and we saw Fairley last night, and we had a little talk.
And that could be...
Nothing official yet.
No, nothing, just unofficial.
And Tim, where is Tim at the moment? He hasn't staged his own...
comeback.
Should we do the award for the best adult contemporary?
I think so.
No, 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 Richard! Hello, everybody! Yes, we've taken over! We're not going to whatever Richard wants to go to! We're going to go do this!
Ice will melt, water will boil. Shake off this mortal coil, it's bigger than us. You don't have to worry about it. Ready or not, here comes a drop. You feel lucky when you know where you are. You know it's gonna come true. Here in your arms, I remember. It's only natural, I should want to.
Basically had the whole valley. Everyone started offering their houses to us.
Houses,
families, chalets.
The time we were there, we had every house between the studio and the beach offered to us for rent at some point.
And by the end of the time, we were renting them all.
Most of them, yeah.
Because we all moved out from this one house. Slowly, everyone went, oh, I've got to get my own place. Yeah. Actual recording or, you know, making the music was a little bit of an interlude. It's like good fun sometimes. What do you think?
Humbling.
Looking at the clouds rolling by and the size proportion of the landscape, and you'd get a lump in your throat.
It added perspective to the whole thing, that's for sure.
I don't pretend to know what you want, but I offer love. I
here we go, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Nick and Paul to the Wall of Death. Evening, boys.
Evening.
How are you this evening?
I'm excited.
You look vacant to me today, Paul. What's wrong with you today? Are you here?
What's wrong? Nothing.
Okay, just checking. Because Paul's always jumping around normally.
Stop jumping around.
Have you stopped jumping around?
Yeah, I'm going to leave that to someone else.
Like me. Well, I can
if you like.
Yeah, I could do that.
If you choose to take that path, I will play you like a shark, and I'll clutch at your heart. I can fly in like a spark to inflame you.
We went to the west coast of Canada. We were in Vancouver. Now let's go to the east coast and let's go to Halifax. You guys, there's another question for you coming up from Halifax this time.
Hi, my name is Sherry Bento and I'm from Halifax, Nova Scotia, and I want to know if Paul Hester will marry my very beautiful 30-year-old single sister.
So what do you think, Paul? Would you marry your sister?
No. No way.
Okay. I see.
Oh, sure.
Are you sure?
I'm absolutely positive on that one. I've already got a beautiful girl that I think if I'm going to marry, I'll marry her.
Oh, okay.
One's enough. Oh, no, you don't need to suck up.
Always something very humorous occurs. You know, a member of the audience decides to come up stage and, you know, does the performance of their life. Or, you know, Paul's usually good for a couple of anarchic moments.
Where is he, by the way?
Paul, he's, I'm not sure at this very moment, he's probably in bed. He's back in Melbourne, he's got a pregnancy to deal with.
He's pregnant?
Yeah, oh, well, he's got several, actually, he's just got to work it out.
Excuse me?
No, just one at the moment. No, he's not here this time, he sends his apologies.
That's too bad, we miss him. All right, let's talk.
Why would a man give up the rock and roll superstardom that so many of us crave? Well, here to answer the question exclusively to this show is the man himself. Please welcome the very tall Mr. Paul Hester.
Oh, yeah. A giant one who's got it.
Of course, that applause may never happen again to you, Paul.
This is true, and that's the risk that I want to take.
The risk you have taken. Now, 3 hours before a gig, that's pretty drastic stuff, Paul.
Nick had gone somewhere, and I found Neil and Mark Hart, and I dragged them into this room, and it was very emotional, and a big outpouring, a few tears, and it was like America's Cup sort of thing, but in reverse. And we went on stage in about 10 minutes after that. So we didn't tell the crew, and we just did this gig that went for about 3 hours or so, 2.5 hours. And after the gig, it was rather... I took the tape and went. And here I am.
Paul, I have to get a bit Willis-y here now. I'm going to get really tough with you. Why? Why quit?
Well, why not? You know, I don't know.
No. Cop out answer. Why?
I just wanted to come home. Yeah, I got a great home. I love it where I am, and I just wanted to be there. And I'm going to be a father like you in a few months.
I hope you're not going to be a father like me for life.
Well, sometimes it's hard. You feel exhausted. There's too much going on. And sometimes you feel.
Disappointing millions of fans around the world with the news they were breaking up, comes one final chance to see Crowded House live in action.
It is our farewell concert on the steps of the Sydney Opera House, and it is a benefit for the Randwick Children's Hospital.
And best of all, it's free. The Sydney Opera House steps will be turned into a giant rock venue for the concert, which will also feature UMI and Powderfinger.
The chance to actually play just one more time is, you know, I can't resist.
It's a paradox. It's a dichotomy, Neil. It's a paradox, Neil. Nick, more fuzz.
Jack, I don't know.
Two guitars, no more fuzz.
Really, really good. Very important to do it for us, you know, for the four of us, because we hadn't actually punctuated any ending much. During that week and everything, a lot of us said, I mean, the four of us said stuff to each other we never probably would have said. And certain things were brought up and dealt with, you know, in a way that was kind of easy. And rehearsals were really fun, and all the good things about being in the crowd is came up to the throat, and it was kind of a great way. Everyone got to leave together, whereas I didn't. I didn't get to leave with everyone before. It was like I just pissed off, and they all kind of went, oh, we'll go on, and, you know. And it was a bit odd, so to come back and all leave together and punctuate it was very, like a huge, you know, it was like the four of us going off to the psychoanalysis. It was great.
Australian Album of the Year, and it goes to Crowded House Recurring Group.
Crowded House are the most successful group in ARIA history, winning 11 awards, and this one's a fitting finale to the year, in which they said goodbye to the world in front of 150,000 people in Sydney.
him alone, will ya? Tim, sit down.
Oh, we'd just like to say we're very emotional too. And we've been emotional for 15 years.
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank the cameraman for letting me on stage finally. But I'd like to thank EMI, who just sold truckloads of those things out the door, and they were, you know, a pretty inspirational performance there. And our manager, Grant Thomas, who pushed the button, and Aaron Thomas sitting next to him, who lent us his father for the last 10 years.
You can have him back. We're finished with him. He's yours. Good luck.
And I've got a recording studio, so I'll be bullshitting on about doing a solo album for the next 10 years.
These four guys have been helping me out with my demos and stuff over the last couple of years, so it's only natural that we got together, you know, it sort of worked out. And, you know, they're sort of should have, you know, except for John, we're all kind of short. John's tall, dark and handsome. And, so, you know, we're called the largest living things.
To you, I hate an avenue. I'm getting hot on those hot rocks. I'm laying next to you. I'm in love with you. My love is, my love's ahead. My love is, my love's ahead. Let's chill. My love's ahead. My love is, my love's ahead. My love's ahead. Let's chill.
It's one gig with the Oils. It's short notice, sure. You got one hand tied behind your back, but I would have thought you'd pull it off, Paul.
Mate, I just barely hung on by the skin of my teeth.
Right.
I had Pete in my face, inches away, going, US forces! And I was just going, geez, man, I didn't remember the chorus. They had one song, they come up, little powwow before every song, come up to Hessie. Okay, Hessie, this one's a slow, this one's got to stop in the chorus, it's got to stop in the chorus. Yeah, it's like funky. No, it's like Motown, slow, easy, just take it easy. This one's an easy one, take it easy. And then they counted in, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm thinking, Jesus, man, I can't wait for the fast one, you know. And then they leave that at the very end of the night, the fastest one. They do that one, I don't want to be the one. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm with you. Get me out of here, Hursty, get back.
Before we start, just a general apology for leaving you guys in Atlanta. Just a general apology there, just to set up straight.
That's all right, because we're off now.
Hang on. Jeez.
It's a bit edgy all of a sudden, isn't it?
I thought I finally met me match. Now look, questions. Questions from the good people to you guys. Oh, look, here's a spicy one. What the fuck went wrong?
Well, whatever it was, it can't have been gone that wrong, because here we are.
Yeah.
Making some fruit salad. Everybody's helping. Barry, what are you up to?
Anthony, I've got some grapes to put in the fruit salad bowl.
And Paul the cook?
Well, I'm mixing up all the fruit in this bowl.
Greg, Anthony, I'm chopping up some melon.
And Jeff, what are you doing over there?
I peel a banana.
Do it all again, real soon, mate. Fruit salad, yummy, yummy. Fruit
salad. Yummy, yummy. Fruit salad. Yummy, yummy. Salad, yummy, yummy.
If I had to take a stand, sell it to them loud and clear. I can't always trust my fate, not to run away and disappear. Possibility, finding it out.
Thought for the day. No, it is wrong. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay. You wanted to say.
You can sing one for Paul with me if you want. Somewhere deep inside, something's got a hold on you, and it's pushing me aside. See it stretch on forever, and I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Stripping back the coats of lies and deception, back to nothingness, like a week in the desert. I know I'm right for the first time in my. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. So don't say no, don't say nothing's wrong. When you get back home, cause me pain if we were to end it, but I could start again. You can depend on me, and I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Oh, and that's why I tell you.
Maybe not.